It's time for the Northwoods Cooking Show. Starring Uncle Roy and Miss Callie, the troublemaking dog.
Hello, and welcome to the Northwoods Cooking Show. I'm your host, Uncle Roy.
And I don't have my camera hands. Oh, I want to cry. Oh, I miss her.
Maybe in some future episodes, I got an invitation to go up for dinner at his house last weekend. And Callie was on me like white on rice. She heard, he said, "Oh, Uncle Roy's here," and I drove in the driveway. She came running out of the house, just barreling out, looking for me. And then she was in there over there, and I go, "Hey, hey, hey, hey!" And she goes, "Brah!" Running over, just hugs and kisses, and all slap, blah, 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 all over. Oh, God, I start crying because I miss her. And then after things settled down, I recorded an episode of Doggy Treats for her at their house. And I just did it on my little camera because, you know, I did the videos in Paris. So I thought, well, I'll try it. And that works out just great. So I'll attach that to this one if I don't have enough Thanksgiving meals, which is the topic for today, is the Thanksgiving meals. Now, I've done turkey way too many times. I think I've done 4 of them already, I think. And cut a few hams and roast beefs and stuff, beef roasts. So today I'm going to concentrate on a couple of side dishes. And these are going to be individual side dishes. So here's the trick, or the benefit. You got your plate and you're having your Thanksgiving meal. You got your turkey and cranberry sauce and stuffing and mashed potatoes and gravy and all that. Well, there's too much food on your plate. You just don't have enough room for all the side dishes. So we're going to put a side dish in here and just put that next to your plate. So you can have more dishes of more food. You know, you can just eat your heart's content. In moderation, but you know what I mean. It just makes it nicer because you got more room then. And we're going to be making au gratin potatoes. Now, what's so big deal about au gratin potatoes? There is no big deal. But these are made with white cheese rather than the cheddar because I've had fellow employees that I work with. There's one girl who's allergic to the FDC reds, yellow, 2, 3, 4, whatever the numbers are. And she can't eat the orange cheddar cheese. So this is made with Swiss cheese. Our second recipe, I'm going to be making a treat. These are going to be macaroons with almonds, which is like contradicted to itself. They just pound it near you. It's not pronounced macaroons, it's macaroons. But that's the macaroon cookie, which is the little sandwich, egg white baked, you know, shell meringue cookies. And this is a macaroon with almonds and a little cherry on top. So that's gonna be kind of fun. So let's get in positions.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time, and I'll be crying all the time because Callie ain't coming. Oh, it ain't the same without her sitting pretty, you know, big in her little paws. Oh, I'm shaking the paws. Sometimes two.
So what we're going to be doing is take our ramekins, and you want to make sure you spray them heavily. Also, whenever you use these things, you know, of course you're going to spray them down. Thing is, wipe them out completely first and make sure they're dry, because if there's moisture in there, the spray isn't going to stick to the side walls of your dishes, and then everything's going to stick to the food's going to stick to the dish, to the ceramic. So it's just no sense to even spray it then, you know. So you want to make sure you wipe out, make sure they're clean. And then we just take and cut up potatoes. For every one ramekin, you have approximately one large potato. And you just want to cut these up into thin slices and then just take and arrange them into your ramekins. Dollar store. Not the family dollar, the dollar one, you know, a Dollar Tree. A dollar, just for these heavy-duty ceramic little ramekins. You can't go wrong with that. So I got for a family of 4 here, and then slice up your potatoes really thin and just put these in your little ramekins. Very nifty, very easy, and very inexpensive. Very inexpensive. $1 a bowl. I remember my mom used to have some turtle ones, fancy ones. I remember the turtles, every time my kids got together for our holiday meals, you know, here was the turtle assortment all over the table for butter and sugar and creamer and salt and pepper, with all these big turtles, like Euro turtle kind of sort of. They're very comical. I remember when nobody was home, I'd take them out of the china closet and play with them like little toys. We had to hear the turtle in the third grade or first grade or something. Anyway, so that's that. Now we're going to make the sauce for it. And basically it's going to be like a roux. So you want to heat up your stove. You want like a medium flame, medium wire, whatever you, medium coil. I hate electric. I just hate electric. Ugh. You don't know how much I hate it. Because you have no control of it. You know, you got to take your pan off and on. So we got that, 2 tablespoons of butter. I got my cheese here, that goes on last. Along with the 2 steps, I'm gonna wait for that to melt first. So I put the flour, now it's not gonna, you know, mix together. I'll just let that melt down. So, as of the taping of the show, it's just a couple days before Halloween. Woo! And this will be my first time at this house giving out treats, if I get here in time. Now, I don't know what time the kids come. Generally speaking, I know it's like late afternoon where it's still bright out, though, when the sun's still up. Because nowadays, they don't take the little kids out after dark. Well, God, that's the whole fun about it, getting scared to death by going out at night, you know? And now that I moved from that, my old place to this place, 5 million houses right back here all around, I'm like, oh my God. Better load up on the candy. Better buy a truckload of candy. But you should see my house. Oh my God. I got this stuff here and a lot of Halloween stuff in the living room. But out front, I got the RIP gravestones around the corner. We are on a corner lot, so I got it on both sides of the sidewalk there. And then I got my scarecrow outfit I wore last year with Callie, and she was the corn dog, you know, the ear corn dog. And so I have my scarecrow outfit out there stuffed with leaves. Sitting in the lawn chair. Well, the father was pushing the stroller with the baby the other day, and they had a golden lab with him. That dog was barking viciously at that scarecrow, just viciously. I'm in here like, what's going on? I'm looking out the window, and that dog's barking. I'm like, God, somebody's out there, you know, causing trouble. And I went outside. No, the scarecrow was sitting in the lawn chair, and that dog was just, thought it was a human being. Which gave me the idea that when I get home from work, put the outfit on and sit in the chair, and then when kids come by, they have heart attacks, scare the crap right out of them. I don't know, we'll see. Well, that gave me that idea right away. Oh God, too funny. Okay, then we need, I don't know why they say it, half a tablespoon, which is 2.5 teaspoons of kosher salt. Gotta put in that kosher salt. And it's lighter, and spoon for spoon, it is, it was 2, 3. It's a little bit less, not quite. Food Network I was watching. And I forget who it was, I know it was a lady. And she was making something rather, and she uses only kosher salt in all her cooking too. And she was saying too, because it's shaved, it's fluffier, so it is less sodium than regular salt, because regular salt's real tiny and all fine powder, whereas kosher's flaky, you know. So it takes up more room, so there's, you know, less sodium. So she goes, be generous with your kosher salt when you cook with it, because it's not as strong as iodized salt. Okay, now what are we doing? 2.5 teaspoons of Italian seasonings.
Thank you.
and a 3/4 teaspoon of black pepper. No, I just got this on a medium heat, so the butter melted, everything's fine. It's not gonna burn that flour. You gotta be careful. So you don't wanna put it on a high heat, because you will burn that flour right away. So don't do that. Keep it on a low heat. That's half and a quarter. Okay, now this is like our roux. You know what the roux is the thickener in all your soups and stuff and sauces. This is gonna be the roux for our sauce. So I just took it off the heat. I don't want to burn it, and you can't set it there and turn off the flame, so you got to move it. Ugh, hate it. Then 2 cups of heavy cream. I can put this back on the stove again. And 2 cups is a pint. Oh, speak of containers, pints, whatever. That's not recyclable, that's wax. Guess what I got? My favorite. Yogurt, yeah. 'Tis the season before Halloween. Eggnog out in the stores. I absolutely love eggnog. I used to have a recipe for it that was just good. I tried one new last year and it was just awful. I got it on the internet, it was terrible. But this is the eggnog, I like the thick stuff. And this is the light one, so it's made with a low fat milk rather than whole milk. Of course, all that sugar and milk dairy products, not good for the diabetes. I gotta shoot up good on that one. Now, we're mixing in this heavy cream with this roux, and this will thicken up really quickly, hopefully. And we're gonna just let it sit here until it simmers. And what's a simmer? I learned this one in France. You know, when you're sitting there and you got the little teeny tiny bubbles around the edge of the pot, but the inside isn't boiling at all, that's your simmer. When it starts to get those teeny bubbles around the edge, then that's your simmer. And she asked us that, my class, that question, you know, how do you can tell when it's simmering? And I just dawned on me, I spurted out that answer, just, you know, it just dawned on me for some reason. And she was, yes, that is exactly right. And I'm like, how did I know that? See, I get these things every once in a while. Okay, let's let that go. Meanwhile, we can get our cheese ready because we need 8 ounces. 8 ounces of cheese, which is a cup, but that's a cup is a liquid 8 ounces. Weight 8 ounces is 2 cups. So we need 2 cups of get shredded Swiss cheese, and if you have the slice, rip it up into tiny pieces, because the smaller pieces, the quicker it's going to melt. Da da da. Getting bubbles? Couple. Okay, what else is going on in life? My gardens out at Medina, the second garden that I do, she's like the envy of the whole neighborhood. I got her mom's. Now, also as a taping of this show, we just got that big blast of that Nordic air. Oh, colder than hell. It was so cold. I couldn't take it this morning. Ooh, it was freezing. I swore I saw a sleet on my windshield. But anyway, she's the envy of all her neighbors now, because I got my mom's planted out there, and they just, what was it, last week, opened. And big old bushels of bright, bright colors, you know, vivid, vivid colors. Everybody else got theirs done over with, and they don't have anything. So everybody out there is dull gray, dead plants. And here she has all these bright colors all over the place. And she's like, Roy, my place is gorgeous. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It was so funny. I just cracked up. I go, where you at? I said, I didn't know we were gonna have this extended long summer. Because I always try to plant that way, you know. And when you buy your mom's, I always buy the ones that are just solid buds, not open, because then they last longer. I'm glad and just like the fall colors this year were so bright and vibrant, because they got to go through their full cycle of growth, and that's how everything was so bright and beautiful this year. Because normally we get a hard frost before they have a chance to fulfill their cycle, and it cuts, you know, freezes them, and they all fall dead off the trees right away. So, let's see, is this warm? Nope. Yep. So let's see, now we put in our cheese. Why does everything get timed when I get done, when I shut up and stop talking? I don't know. People are telling me that too. They're like, oh my God, here goes Ryan, one of his tangents again. Holy crap. Oh my God, oh my God. I said, I know, but when I do my editing, one time I had to cut out a whole hour of my off the recipe track and start, you know, telling my stories. A whole hour. That's only a half hour show. Sometimes I know I get carried away. So that's that. Now we're going to make the sauce for it. And basically it's going to be like a roux. So you want to heat up your stove. You want like a medium flame, medium wire, whatever your medium coil. I hate electric. I just hate electric. Ugh. You don't know how much I hate it. Because you have no control of it. You know, you got to take your pan off and on. So we got that, 2 tablespoons of butter. We're gonna wait for that, I'm gonna wait for that to melt first. So I put the flour, now it's not gonna, you know, mix together. Let's let that melt down. Okay, then we need, I don't know why they say it, half a tablespoon, which is 2.5 teaspoons of kosher salt. Yeah, put in that kosher salt. And it's lighter, and Food Network I was watching. And I forget who it was. I know it was a lady. And she was making something or other, and she uses only kosher salt in all her cooking, too. And she was saying, too, because it's shaved, it's fluffier. So it is less sodium than kosher, than regular salt, because regular salt's real tiny and all fine powder, whereas kosher's flaky, you know. So it takes up more room. So this, you know, less sodium. 2.5 teaspoons of Italian seasonings. 3/4 teaspoon of black pepper. No, I just got this on a medium heat, so the butter melted, everything's fine. It's not gonna burn that flour. You gotta be careful. So you don't wanna put it on a high heat, because you will burn and brown that and burn that flour right away. So don't do that. Keep it on a low heat. And 2 cups of heavy cream. I can put this back on the stove again. And 2 cups, this is a pint. Now, we're mixing in this heavy cream with this roux, and this will thicken up really quickly, hopefully. And we're gonna just let this sit here until it simmers. And what's a simmer? I learned this one in France. You know, when you're sitting there and you got the little teeny tiny bubbles around the edge of the pot, but the inside isn't boiling at all, that's your simmer. When it starts to get those teeny bubbles around the edge, then that's your simmer. And she asked us that, my class, that question, you know, how do you can tell when it's simmering? And I just dawned on me, I spurted out that answer, just, you know, it just dawned on me for some reason. And she was, yes, that is exactly right. And I'm like, how did I know that? See, I get these things every once in a while. 8 ounces of cheese, which is a cup, but that's a cup is a liquid 8 ounces. Weight 8 ounces is 2 cups. So we need 2 cups of, get shredded Swiss cheese, and if you have the slice, rip it up into tiny pieces, because the smaller pieces, the quicker it's gonna melt. Oh, that's melting in there really nice. Oh, is this ever pretty, look at that. But you wanna make sure you stir this up now so we get that cheese all melted and mixed in with the sauce. Preservative, and salt. In fact, you should even cut the salt down to even just 1 teaspoon. Because you got cheese has a lot of salt in it, so you don't need any more of that salt. You really don't. I should have only put in 1 teaspoon rather than the 2.5. Oh, which one? Oh, I got, what's the oven? I gotta keep the oven on. Okay. Oh, I hate lactic, God, you know. Oh, you don't know how much I hate it. And I might have a lot of sauce left over here too, I think. I'm pretty sure. Now we just pour this over the potatoes, and we're gonna put in a 1/3 cup. Well, just put in until the potatoes are just about completely covered, but not overly flowing, because as they bake and puff up, it's gonna push that cheese out all over the place, so not too much. Oh, I got pour spots on this one. This is new pots and pans I bought when I moved in here. I had never used this yet. Oh, a little spot, how nice. That makes it nice to pour it in. Ooh. In fact, let me get the pan first. It makes it easier to transfer if you have empty bowls or containers. Put them on your tray first so you can just carry the whole tray when they're full. And you don't have to spill them as readily. And I'll just use my fork here. I'm gonna stir this up, make sure these are kind of well covered. I'm sure it's all dry under here, especially if you packed them down.
If I didn't care more than words can say, if I didn't care, would I feel this way? If this isn't love, then why do I thrill? And what makes my head go round and round while my heart stands still? If I didn't care, would it be the same? Would my air...
Now this is supposed to cover, recipe is supposed to cover 6 ramekins, but these ramekins are about maybe a third larger than the average ones. I think the average ones are about exactly 1 cup maybe, and I think these might be like 1 1/4 or 1 1/3 maybe. So you don't know how good that tastes. Ugh. But like I said, we're going to take and you lower the sodium, only put in a teaspoon. You don't need all that salt. Cheese is very salty. Okay, so we got the sprinkle down there and I put it in the oven, 350, and it's gonna take at least 1 hour, maybe 5 minutes. So when you wanna check it at 45 minutes, use a sharp paring knife, and when you poke into the potato slices, if they're tender and soft, then they're done. Okay, so while the potatoes are baking, we can go on to the cookie recipe, and I wanna get this through. I got a quick jabba walking and get into the recipe because I'm going to run out of time here. Okay, 2 egg whites beaten stiff. Then we pour in 1 cup of almond meal. Remember, we use this on the macaroons, and you can get this at Trader Joe's. I couldn't find it at Cub, but Trader Joe's has it, almond meal. So you want 1 cup of that and 2/3 cup of white sugar. And these all get mixed together. We're gonna fold them in together until they're thoroughly mixed. Use a rubber spatula and fold that in gently because we don't wanna deflate the egg whites. And then just put the curl side down so you don't, you know, flip up on you. And it's no big deal if it does. The other thing you can do too to keep it from flipping is just take a dab of dough and just stick it under each corner, and that'll glue it to the pan if it bothers you that much. I know. Okay. Ooh, I forgot to say hello to the fishies. Only thing from the other place, plus the doggy treat. What do you think I saved? Anyway, you want to drop these by little teaspoons. I suppose you could drop them, you know, the tinier the better, for like a real, because they'll cook up real fast. But I'm just going to do my traditional cookie scooper size. And I suppose you want to put these at least 2 inches apart because it is a meringue. It should hold its peak and just bake up right where it's sitting. But I never tried this recipe before, so I don't know if they're gonna spread out or not. So I'm just gonna be a little bit on the wary side. Wary side too, huh? Okay, so now these are gonna go into our oven until they're done. Check in 8 minutes. General rule is about 8 to 10. Now if you wanted to, you could take those potato slices, put them in an oven proof, microwave proof bowl, and heat them up in the microwave before baking them. And that would be done quicker. But you don't get that rich flavor soaked into them. And look at these. Ooh. Allie, Allie here should be like, sniss, 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 sniss. And I'd be like, no, 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 no. You can burn your tongue if you eat that right now. Let those sit for at least 15, 20 minutes. Those things are extremely hot, and the casserole dish themselves are hot too, so it'll be quite a while. Okay, and here's our au gratin potatoes, done with a Swiss cheese and a roux. Ooh, Italian spices. Ooh, and the secret ingredient, honey roasted Cheerios on top. Didn't that turn out nice and brown? Golden.
Very hot.
Oh. Let that cool down a lot, but that is so good. Oh. And the cookies are done at the same time too. Oh, that's wonderful. This is going to be a fabulous side dish to your Thanksgiving dinner. Make sure you make this. Oh, it's fabulous. And like I said, they're individual, so you know, you can just take and if you don't serve them all, you know, you can freeze it, put it, wrap it up in foil and freeze wrap and put it in. And now cookies. Oh, these look familiar now. Now I remember these. Ooh, ooh, ooh. They do spit out. And I'm not gonna touch that one with my hand, I'll burn it. Let these cool to room temperature. These are kind of semi-soft now. The 8 minutes is up. But you don't want to remove them now because you want them to cool completely to room temperature because they're soft. You go to spatula them off, they're going to just stretch apart because they are soft. But remember now, this is like all sugar and flour basically. So when these cool to room temperature, they're going to be harder and they'll be able to break away then. They're not going to be soft. So, happy Thanksgiving. Wish you well and hope you have a wonderful time. And I say a lot of prayers for each other. And eat healthy, be safe, and spread the sunshine. Thank you, and bye-bye. Love you, Callie.